What is my perspective on music today? I feel music, it took a turn from, I'm not going to say the worst, but it's not the best either. I mean, you know, I got this big thing. I'm just like KRS-One and Buckshot when it comes to this thing about everybody can sing now with the auto-tune and stuff like that. So it's not as creative as I thought it would be. You know, it's like cats is getting lazy now. They ain't really putting no effort behind what they're doing. Everybody's in for the quick buck. I mean, like, where's the love? You know what I mean? But on the R&B side of things, I mean, they're doing their thing, but then you got certain cats, you know, I can't be naming cats, that still mess around with the auto-tune and all that to make themselves sing, you know. Everybody want to rap, everybody want to sing. But for the true players in the game, I mean, they definitely doing their thing, like Jay. You see how I got stuck on Jay. Because it ain't too many cats out there like keeping it real as far as music. It's like they going alternative routes. I mean, like I said earlier, to me it's about the quick buck now. It's too flashy and flamboyant. Nobody's really being creative no more. I mean, that's like in a nutshell. It's like really nothing I can really say. That's why you got cats like me, old schoolers, that, you know, we set trends for the game. I'm an unsung hero, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I have my deals and stuff like that, but I didn't really get the recognition I felt I deserved. But people know me, and the thing is, you know, that's why cats like me always stay in the background, always stay in the picture, you know what I'm saying? Because we help cats that design themselves to be better, you know what I'm saying? Because right now it's like nobody out there has a clue. What kind of effect do I want to have on music? Basically, I just want to make an impact. I want to let them know, like, y'all doing something wrong. I mean, we've struggled for years since hip-hop started to keep a fire under it, to keep it going. And it's like, by y'all showing that y'all running out of ideas, it's like they're killing hip-hop. You know what I'm saying? Hip-hop is not just music. I mean, hip-hop is an art form. I mean, hip-hop is another form of poetry, a way people express their feelings. I mean, when you coming out with these no-idea records, I mean, where's the creativity level at? I mean, the effect I want to have on the game is, like I said, I'm going to come out as the truth and tell cats, if you whack, you whack. I mean, if record companies are signing you to make a quick buck, I'm going to tell you that's what they're doing to you. Now, if you greedy and you with that, then so be it. Like KRS-One said, that's what you do. That's what you choose. We wore them hats. We wore them shoes. We wore them clothes and pants. We talk all that drugs and beat up on the block and best fighter stuff, but it don't matter, you know what I'm saying? It really don't matter no more. I mean, that's where y'all got us at in hip-hop. I mean, when are we gonna go back to talking about what's going on in our communities and trying to open up people's eyes to what's going on? Because that's what hip-hop was about. It was our voice, you know what I'm saying? Hip-hop was another way of our communities speaking to people that won't listen to us, you know what I'm saying? And now y'all taking it and y'all giving them exactly what they want. Now y'all giving them your money, and at the same time you're showing them, oh, we don't have no creativity. That's jungle music. That's black music. That's how they classify it. It ain't classified as music. You know what I'm saying? It's supposed to be classified as music because it is an art form. Let me see, if I had to work with anybody in the game, if I really wanted to, I would have to say, hands down, Dr. Dre. I mean, that's like number one. I'm like a number one fan. I'm like, that's my dude. You give me any beat by Dre, I'll convert from being a producer, CEO of my own company and all that. And I'll go back to being a rapper like I was in the beginning, just to rhyme on a Dre beat. You know what I'm saying? And I go back on the thing I said about auto-tune. You could auto-tune me and all that, long as it's a Dre beat. You know what I'm saying? Because anything Dre put out, you know, it's a guaranteed hit. You know what I'm saying? I mean, this man's beats is incredible. I mean, I feel I'm a big fan and a big protege of Dre. I mean, everything I do when it comes to beats and music, it's like I go in Dre style. I mean, ask any studio I've ever worked in, the first thing I say out my mouth is, let me put the Dre on it. And they look at me like I'm crazy because they don't understand what I'm talking about. But I'm talking about I'm going in there with the ears, the eyes, the nerves, the feeling in my heart. I mean, that's how Dre rock, and that's how, like, I rock. Anybody else, I would say KRS-One, DJ Premier, the likes of, I would say Jay-Z, but everybody want to rock with Jay, you know what I'm saying? But you know, that's an everybody thing. I'm picking, like, heavy hitters. I would even take it back to, you could give me an Africa Bambaataa beat. I'll take it back to the Essence on that. You know what I'm saying? It's not too many cats I really want to work with. I mean, Dre is, like, ultimate number one. I mean, it's not really nobody else. Everybody else is, like, secondary. And to me, if you're secondary, then you can wait. You know what I'm saying? But Dre, if you come up and you say, yo, 20, I got this beat for you. You want to rhyme? I'll be, hell yeah. You know, I don't waste no time on that. That's about basically where I go. Unless it's my beat, you know, I rock on my joints, you know what I'm saying? How long I've been rocking? I've been rocking in this game since the game started. I mean, I started off young, about 11, 12 years old. You know, in my book, if you read my book, A Brick Out of Place, it tells you, you know, I was a latchkey kid. I was one of them kids that didn't really go outside and all that. And at my time, me coming up, there was, like, really no music shows and stuff like that. I mean, Video Music Box and New York City Hot Tracks ain't come out for a minute, and I was already in the music. I mean, Mean Machine, Funky 4 Plus One More, Treacherous 3, Grandmaster Flash, Melly Mel, The Furious 5, and all that. I mean, that's where I was at. I was out when records looked bootleg, you know what I'm saying? But these was official record companies putting out records. But when you look at the records from back then to the way they making the records now, that's how long I've been out. I was out when it was just an idea. A cat took a piece of wax, put some music on it, and they made their own labels. I mean, remember PSK? He drew his label, Schooly D. He drew his own label. You know what I'm saying? So that's the era where I came from, you know? So I've been in this game for a long time. I've seen a lot. I've heard a lot. I've done a lot, you know? And I know what I'm looking for because that's where I come from. I'm just one. It wasn't the fact that I didn't hold on to the deals. And I keep it real. I don't want to sound like a flake, but I ran with a lot of bum dudes. They couldn't hold on to the deal. You know what I'm saying? Because I remember back in the days, the DJ was the back man and the MC was the front man. And every contract cats got back in the days, the front man was the one that got signed. And we was like his band. So me as a DJ, for every MC I got signed with, I was they one man band. But when they got chumped off the label, I got chumped with them, you know, we a group. And it was kind of a real experience too, because if I'm running with you, you don't want me to cut your throat and they kick you off and I stay there. I mean, what kind of sucker shit is that, you know? So, you know, I ran with it. I took my bumps and bruises. And every label that I was on, from Ventertainment to Island Records, you know what I'm saying? They always told me, they said, yo, 20, we want you to come back. But the problem was, cats wasn't holding the weight lyrically back then. I mean, cats was nice back then. Compared to the cats now, cats was nice back then. Where are those cats?